guys, so the purpose of my video today is to show you how to manage your recall groups. So I am assuming at this point that you have already created your groups. If you need assistance with that, please jump back to the last video called Creating Recall Groups. So we are looking at our recall groups management screen. And as you can see, I've got groups for October, November, December 2020, and then February down to July 2021. I've done them deliberately in this way. As I touched on in the last video, rename your groups to something really obvious to see. So much easier to manage them than if you just have a date range up here in the title. So I'm just going to have a look at this November 2020 group. I can see we've got a 22% success rate and we've got a 25% appointment creation rate. That tells me that there's probably one or two patients in there, depending on the size of the group, that have got an appointment booked that haven't yet completed it, and that there's about 75% of people in there that still have not booked an appointment. We want that to be a much higher figure for our success rate, because we are looking at November 2020 and we're now in July. So this is months and months old. Ideally, this should be at 100% success rate in a perfect world. So let's have a look in further detail. I can see we've got a next appointment booked in for Grace Anatomy. I love this group. Oh, you guys are so funny. I'm not sure who made that, but that's fantastic. So we've got Grace Anatomy, and she is booked in for an appointment on the 3rd of the 7th. So it highlights that for us so that we know we don't need to send her an SMS reminder. So coming over to the appointment book, let me show you what happens when she successfully completes her appointment. This success rate will jump up to 25%. So I'll move her. She's booked in tomorrow. I'm just going to move her today so that I can complete that appointment. She's having a 011 done. Now, I've got my auto recall setting turned on, which means when I go to her patient file now, it will have automatically updated her recall for me, and it's been set for the 4th of January 2022, so that's 6 months from today. So we'll close that, close all of this. Coming back over to our recall group for November, I can see we've now got a 25% success rate. And we've now got 9 patients who have completed it, and there's 27 still left in the group. This patient, Grace, will have now been removed from the group. We do this deliberately. We don't want to keep patients in there if they've successfully completed their recall, because you may accidentally send them a reminder for something that they've already had done. So as soon as they've successfully completed their recall, they are removed from the group, but they do contribute to that overall success rate. Now, for some of these older groups, you may want to make them a little bit more manageable. At the moment, we've got quite a few groups going on here. As these are all from last year, and they're all over 6 months old, I'd probably combine these all into one group. So I can do that quite easily by clicking on one of the groups, and I can move these recalls to another group. And I might just move them all into December 2020. And I'll do the same for November. So I've got all of my patients selected, move them to another group, and we'll say December 2020. Done. So now we've got 2 less groups to work with. I can change this description if I want to, so edit group details, and maybe instead of December 2020, I'll say 2020 overdue. And done. So when I close that now, I can see out of all of the patients that were in here, I've only got a 6% success rate. But now they're all in grouped in here together. I don't have to worry about going in and out of each group. I can just contact them all together. Days since last action over here. I want you to pay close attention to this one. This is the last time that you attempted to contact these patients. Ideally, I wouldn't let any of these go over 14 days. So that's 2 weeks. you should be contacting the patient every 2 weeks until they come back in. That's just my experience when I was in charge of recalls. Your practice may operate a little bit differently, and that's absolutely fine. But just try not to let this figure get too high, because the longer it's been since you've contacted them, the less time, the less likely it is that you're going to get them to rebook for an appointment. You can order these by days since last action. So some of these patients you've never contacted. So I'd start there. We can unselect all of them, or we can select patients without appointments. For your groups where you do have patients that have a future appointment booked, you don't have to manually go through and unselect them. You can just go down here, select patients without appointments, and it will unselect all of those ones for you. From our experience, the best way to get a patient to rebook an appointment is by sending them an SMS. It's a very instant thing that they get directly to their mobile phone, which these days is where most patients are booking their appointments from. Whether they do that online or whether you pop your practice phone number in there and they click on that and call you directly, but SMS is proven to be the most effective way of recalling patients. Another thing you can do is email them. That's absolutely fine to do. It's a free method of communication. Keep in mind though, these days, you can't guarantee that your patient is going to receive that email. Unfortunately, so many of the email accounts are blocking emails from coming through. They're being marked as spam. All it takes is one patient to mark it as spam, and then you may see some of your other patients not receive your emails, which is really unfortunate and something that we don't have any control over. It's just sort of the way that the world is going now. There's so many spam accounts out there that everything is being blocked. But if you are fortunate enough to have your patients receiving your emails regularly, then that's great. You click on email down here and you can select your template. If you're wanting assistance setting up your templates, just reach out to us. I will be making a video on that fairly soon. But you'd select your template from over here. I'm just going to use one of these as an example. I think I've got a recall. Yes, I do. Recall letter there. And I can use my selected template. And then it's being sent from Praktika Dental. This will be your practice email address to 62 recipients, and then the subject is recall. Now you can change this. You might want to say you are due for your dental checkup, for example. You can force send this email to people who have chosen not to be contacted via email. That is set up in their personal details. It's optional. I personally wouldn't do this for patients, because if they've said they don't want to receive emails, if you're sending them an email like this, you might just upset them. And then it's not likely that they will return, but you may have other reasons for wanting to send them through an email. So completely optional. You can leave it ticked or unticked, and then press send when you're ready. Now this is a test account, so I'm not going to send because I'm not sure who has set up their email addresses in here. But that's how it would be done. Once that's been sent, it's going to change this days since last action to today. I'll show you how that looks just by recording an event. So I'll do a quick template. My summary is just going to be email sent. This is exactly what would happen if you were to send an email to these people. I'm just showing you what it looks like without inconveniencing some of the people that may accidentally receive this email. You can leave a note over here and that's fine. And we'll press save. And now we can see days since last action is zero for all of these people. Something to keep an eye out for when you are sending your communications to your patients is this day since last action. Just because you have selected all patients here and sent them an SMS or an email does not necessarily mean that it has been sent to them. You will have patients who do not have a mobile phone number or who do not have an email address. We will let you know over here if it was successfully sent or not. If your patient doesn't have an email address, nothing will change over here because it won't have been able to send anything to them. So keep an eye on it. Gradually work your way through the list. When I was managing recalls in a practice, I would start by SMS, then I'd move on to email, then I'd come back to another SMS, around a month after the original one. And then after that, it would be tailored phone calls for each of the patients, trying to get them to book back in. So go through with your owners, with everyone in the practice, see what your preferred method of communicating with your patients is, and take it from there. I would be looking at these recalls at least once a week. This is an area that is essential to your practice. It does require some manual work, but it's so worthwhile having a staff member do this for you. Even if you allocate a couple of hours a week just for recalls, if you manage to book in two or three patients each time you spend a couple of hours doing those recalls, you've made money, because you may have spent, let's say, for example, $100 for that staff member to contact all of those patients, and you've made several hundred dollars back on that by those patients booking back in for their exam and their clean. So it's a worthwhile area to focus on. Routinely visiting patients are the main money makers of your practice. That's your bread and butter. Anything on top of that is a bonus. So that's this area as a quick overview. It's how I would be working around it. If you have any specific questions, please reach out to us, and we're happy to help you through. Thank you so much.